Hey everyone, today I'm going to be showing you my magnetic accelerator ring launcher. Now watch this. Whoa! Now before I show you how awesome this is and how fast we can accelerate pieces of metal instantly, let me explain how it works. When an electron moves through space, it creates a changing electric field, obviously, because as the electron's moving, it has a field around it, and that field follows the electron. But as an electron moves through space, a changing electric field also creates a magnetic field. So what that means is if you move an electron, you create a magnetic field. So I have two wires here. The electrons are going to travel down the black wire, turn around, and come back this direction. So the directions of the electrons in both wires are opposite. In this wire, it's going this way, and in the red wire, it's going this way. So I have just these wires hanging here, and you can see about how close they are together. But now watch what happens when I flow a current through them. 3, 2, 1. Now look how far apart they are. And then stop the current, and they go back together. And then if I pulse it, I can really get these swinging. So what's happening here is, as the current moves through these wires, it's creating a magnetic field. And the way you can tell which way the magnetic field's going is, if you point in the direction of the current, your fingers will point in the direction of the magnetic field. So it's gonna curve around this wire in this direction. It's gonna come around like this. And in this wire, the current's going the opposite direction, so you're gonna have the magnetic field pointing the opposite direction. So it's going to go like this. So because you have these two magnetic fields pointing in the opposite direction, that means that they're actually going to repel each other. Now in this case, the magnetic field was kind of coiled around it in a cylindrical shape. But what if we wanted a more traditional shape of a magnet with a true north and south pole? Well then, we just coil our wires instead. For example, let me just take my wire and coil it around this. So see how this can't pick it up at all right now? But then when I connect the wire, now it can. Then release it, and it drops. So we've shown that if you have moving electrons or a changing electric field, you can create a magnetic field. And what's interesting is the reverse of that is also true. If you have a changing magnetic field, you can create an electric field or an electric potential. For example, you can see that I just wrapped a bunch of wire around this paper towel roll here, and here's my two ends connected to a voltmeter here. So let's look at the voltage as I move a magnet by this coil of wire here. So notice how if I just set the magnet here, there's no voltage whatsoever. It has to be moving. So when I move the magnet, it creates a voltage on the wires. But what's interesting about this is when I move the magnet past the coil of wire, it creates a voltage. And that voltage pushes electrons in the wire. But we know that when you have electrons moving in a wire, it creates its own magnetic field. But the only thing is, the magnetic field is going to be pointing the opposite direction of the magnet that caused it all. So that means that when I move the magnet past this coil of wire, I kind of feel a resistance. And that's because I'm causing electrons to move in there, which create a magnetic field, which push back on the magnet. And you can see this a little bit clearer if I just replace this coil of wire with a flat piece of metal. You'll notice that aluminum by itself is not magnetic at all. Aluminum has no ferromagnetic properties. It doesn't stick to a magnet. And just for reference, this is what it looks like when it slides off something. Pretty predictable, right? But watch what happens when I try to slide it off this magnet. It's almost as though it sticks to the corners. It doesn't want to move fast past them. Pretty cool. That's because as the electrons in the metal move past the magnetic field in the magnet, it causes the electrons to move around in circles, tiny little circles that are called eddy currents. And those eddy currents create a magnetic field of their own that opposes this magnetic field. And so basically it creates small little electromagnets in this piece of metal that oppose the force of whatever it's doing. So whatever way you try to move it, it creates a force that opposes that. And this is called Lenz's law. And you notice that the reason that it does it more on the corners is because this is the region of the highest changing magnetic field. And that's the place where it gets caught up the most, because that's the place of the highest changing magnetic field. And you can see that when I cut little slots in it, so I make it so that it can't form little loops of electricity, it doesn't get caught up on the corners as much. So basically, it's not allowing eddy currents to form anymore in the metal. And so what happens when you have a changing magnetic field near a piece of metal, that piece of metal will oppose the magnetic field that induced the current that made the magnetic field in the first place. And so what I have here is just a coil of wire wrapped around an iron core, and this is connected to my AC voltage. And so it's creating a changing magnetic field because the electrons are going back and forth and back and forth 60 times per second. So now watch what happens when I stick a piece of metal by this changing magnetic field. 3, 2, 1. So let's give ourselves a little more room and see how high this goes. 3, 2, 1. That was awesome. So this is just a piece of aluminum. You can see here's an iron nail and my aluminum. It's not magnetic at all. So the only thing that's causing it to fly up is the eddy currents created inside of it, and those eddy currents create a magnetic field that opposes the changing magnetic field that's causing the eddy currents. And so it pushes it away from it. And I can prove that it's the eddy currents moving around in a circle that's causing a magnetic field to oppose this one, and that's the reason it's flying away. For example, here's a complete ring. And here's a ring with a slit in it, so it's not a complete circuit now. You can see nothing happens. Now remember, the strength of the magnetic field that's induced in this aluminum cylinder here is dependent on the current that's flowing through it. One way that I can reduce the resistance and increase the current through it is to reduce the temperature, because as temperatures go down, resistance goes down. So if I put this in liquid nitrogen, I should be able to get it to go a lot higher than I could at room temperature. Let's try it. So here it is at room temperature. Now here it is at liquid nitrogen temperatures. Whoa! That's awesome. Now watch this. Whoa! So the energy from my AC wires here are going into launching the ring. Now if I don't give that energy anywhere to go, it has to go into heat. For example, if I don't let this launch, if I just hold it in place, watch what happens. Okay. I gotta hold it a little tighter. Look at that instantly heat up, watch. So you can see when I stick two magnets on here, how the magnetic field of this is going to alternate. See how it spins it? 1, 2, 3, jump. Hey everyone, thanks for watching another episode of the Action Lab. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. And thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.